this is a question number 5. So what is the definition of a virus? Here we are dealing with a virus. So what is the definition of a virus? Viruses means it is, okay, it is a program or a piece of a code that is loaded onto your computer without your knowledge and runs against your wishes. Okay, viruses can also replicate themselves. All computer viruses are man-made. Viruses copy themselves to other disks to spread to other computers. So these are some definitions of a virus. Okay, so we will be dealing with the next question. Okay, our next question is, we have to give some examples of a viruses. What are some examples of the viruses? So the examples of the computer viruses are microviruses, boot virus, logic bomb virus, then directory virus, and then resident virus. Okay, so these are some definition of viruses and there are some examples. Let's begin to our next discussion. Our next question is, what is Trojan horses? Give few examples. So the Trojan horses. A Trojan horse program has the appearance of having a useful and a desired function. A Trojan horse neither replicates nor copies itself, but causes damage or compromises the security of the computer. A Trojan horse must be sent by someone or carried by another program and may arrive in the form of a joke program or software of some sort. Okay, and the next point is, these are often used to capture your logins and passwords. So these are a Trojan horse. Okay, it is a program. It has the appearance of having a useful and a desired function. It neither replicates nor copies itself. Okay, so it causes a damage only. It captures your logins and the passwords. Okay, let's move to the next question. Our next question. We have to some give examples of the Trojan horses. So the Trojan horses are remote access Trojans and the backdoor Trojans. And the next is IRC Trojans, that is also called as IRC bots. And then the key logging Trojans. So these are some examples of the Trojans. The question number 8, what are worms? We have to give a proper definition for the worms. A computer worm, it is a self-replicating computer program. It uses a network to send copies of itself to other nodes, computers on the network, and it may do so without any user intervention. It does not need to attach itself to an existing program. So it is a worm. Okay, so the next question is, what is spyware? We have to give a proper definition for the spyware. Spyware, it is a type of a malware that is installed on your computers that collects information about users without their knowledge. The presence of a spyware is typically hidden from the user and can be difficult to detect. Spyware programs lurk on your computer to steal important information, okay, like your passwords, like your logins and other personal identification information, and then send it off to someone else. The meaning of a spyware, we mean to say that spying over someone using somewhere, so using means software, that is called a spy software, means spyware. Okay, so these are some definitions of a spyware. What are spyware? It is basically a spying over someone's. Okay, the next question is, what is zombie? So the zombie, it is a program to take control of your computer and use it and its internet connection to attack other computers or networks to perform other criminal activities. So these are a definition of a zombie. It is a program that takes control of your computer, okay? And it will use that zombie, that malware, zombie malware. It uses your computer and uses your internet connections to attack other computers in a network or to perform some other criminal activities. Okay, so these are some definitions of the zombie. We will discuss our next question in next video. Till then, thank you very much for watching.